Hi, and welcome back to another episode of Jeff and Joe's Puerto Rican Kitchen, where we show you how to make easy, authentic Puerto Rican recipes. We are so excited for Thanksgiving. It's just around the corner, and all I'm thinking about is what we're gonna serve for our meal. So we came up with the perfect plan for our dessert, and that's pumpkin flan, flan de calabaza. It's the perfect combination of that fall flavor from the pumpkin and then that creaminess from our flan recipe. So this is one you're really going to enjoy, and I'm sure your guests are going to enjoy it even more. So what are we gonna need is, we're gonna need 1 cup of sugar for the caramel. Then we're going to make what we call the suero, which is literally translated as an IV. And it's just gonna have 1 cup of water, 1 cinnamon stick, and 4 cloves. Then I'm showing here, this is pumpkin. We're going to be using 1 cup of cooked pumpkin. This is uncooked because I'm gonna show you guys how to cook it. But once we cook it, we're actually gonna use only 1 cup. And we're gonna add a little bit dash of salt with the water, about 4 cups of water when we start boiling that. Then for the flan recipe, we're going to be needing 1 can of evaporated milk, 1 can of sweetened condensed milk, 4 ounces or 1/2 packet of cream cheese, 1/4 cup of sugar, and 4 eggs. That's it, let's get cooking.
The first thing we want to do to prepare this flan is to get that pumpkin cooking. We're starting with fresh calabaza. Alternatively, you could use canned squash, but I highly recommend starting with fresh pumpkin since all you have to do is boil it. Turn on the stove on high and add about 4 cups of water to a medium-sized pan. Add the pumpkin and a dash of salt and mix to combine. Let it boil for about 10 minutes or until the pumpkin is soft enough for a fork to easily pierce through it. Then turn off the stove and drain the pumpkin. Measure out 1 cup and set aside to cool. Next, we're going to prepare the caramel. We have shown you this process several times in this channel. Add the sugar in an even layer to a saucepan over medium-high heat. Once the sugar at the bottom starts melting, begin stirring continuously with a heat-resistant spatula. As you're stirring, make sure to scrape down the sides of your pot as well as dislodging anything that gets stuck to the bottom. After a couple of minutes of stirring, the sugar will clump up and form hard, rock-like chunks. Press down on the larger clumps to break them up so they melt faster. Continue stirring constantly until the caramel is an even golden brown. This usually takes me 4 to 5 minutes. Once your caramel is the right consistency, take it off the heat and then, while it's still hot, pour the caramel into a bundt pan in order to coat the bottom and sides of the pan. To do this, hold the pan with oven mitts. It's going to get really hot, and tilt the pan from side to side until the caramel coats all sides of the pan. Once you have finished spreading the caramel across the bottom of your bundt pan, set it aside to cool. With the caramel ready, let's move on to the suero or infused water. Turn on the stove on high. In a large heavy pot, combine the water, cinnamon stick, and cloves. Mix all the ingredients and let it boil for 5 minutes. At the end of the 5 minutes, turn off the stove and strain the mixture. Set it aside to cool. We are now ready to move on to the flan mixture. In the food processor or blender, add the 1 cup of cooked pumpkin, evaporated milk, sweetened condensed milk, 3 tablespoons of the infused water, and blend until everything is well combined, about 15 to 20 seconds. Use a spatula to scrape down the sides of the food processor. Then add the cream cheese and the sugar and blend until smooth. This will take approximately 2 minutes. You want to make sure that the cream cheese is well incorporated and there are no clumps to ensure a smooth finish to your flan. Once the mixture is smooth, you can taste the mixture and adjust if necessary for more sugar or infused water. Finally, add the eggs to the blender or food processor. Blend your mixture until just incorporated, approximately 10 seconds. With the flan mixture ready, let's add it to the prepared baking pan. Gently pour the flan mixture into the baking pan. Now you're ready to bake your flan. Start by preheating your oven to 350 degrees Fahrenheit. Just like we showed you in our earlier flan video, you want to bake your flan in a bain-marie, which is just a fancy name for a water bath. This helps prevent the flan from getting too hot, which would cause the eggs in your flan to overcook. To set up your bain-marie, place a large, deep baking pan into the oven. Fill the pan with hot water to about 1/4 of the way up the side. Then place the flan inside the baking pan and add more water to the baking pan until the water level is about halfway up the side of the bundt pan. Be really careful when adding the water, making sure not to splash any water into the flan. Bake for 1 hour or until the top of the flan looks firm and it softly jiggles in the middle when shaken. Once cooked, remove your flan from the oven and let it cool to room temperature. Once it reaches room temperature, cover with aluminum foil and place it in the fridge for at least 6 hours. To unmold, run a knife along all the edges of the bundt pan. Then lightly shake the mold to make sure that the flan is loose. Next, grab your serving tray. The tray should be at least an inch larger than the bundt pan. Put the tray container on top of the baking mold and flip the flan onto the tray. Enjoy!
Well, the flan is ready and I am very excited for this one. I think this is certainly the perfect Thanksgiving dessert recipe. It's just, you know, has that great fall flavor, you know, just combines pumpkin. But you know what the best thing is? You can make it ahead, 1-2 days ahead, and then just wait to flip it until the day of Thanksgiving. So it's great if you're gonna be cooking a whole bunch of stuff that day and you don't want to be spending as much time on the dessert, you can definitely try this one. So let's give it a try. It's good. That pumpkin flavor comes through and those, you know, cinnamon and clove flavor really comes through as well, but it's still so creamy. I know a lot of you have really enjoyed our flan video and I think this is a great variation, so highly recommended. Please like this video. Hope you really enjoy it. Subscribe to our channel if you haven't done that. Hit that bell button so you receive notifications. And we'll see you again next week for another episode of Jeff and Joe's Puerto Rican Kitchen.